Hey guys, last year I decided to start doing an annual fitness test. I chose 20 different tests and measurements to track every year as I age. I've just finished my testing for year two, and in this video, I'll introduce some of the new tests that I did and share all of my results. The idea behind the annual fitness test was that as I age, I'd be able to see how my strength and fitness change over time. Most of the tests have normative values, meaning I'd be able to see what's considered good, average, or poor, given my age and sex. If you're someone who enjoys this sort of testing, then I highly recommend you try some of them out. I'm planning to make kind of tutorial videos for each test to show how to do it and put those in a big playlist on my channel. So here's a list of everything I tested last year, broken down into categories. My wife was doing the tests as well, and in some cases she had alternative exercises. I was fully expecting the testing protocol to evolve over the years, and it already has. So here are the changes for 2023. I'm taking out fasted glucose for practical purposes. The test strips expire every year, so I'd be paying each time, and HbA1c is a better measure anyway. I was on the fence about fingertip to floor distance, but it doesn't feel like it's going to tell me that much over the years. The dreaded bleep test has gone, only to be replaced by the 12-minute Cooper test. Finally, the Mensa IQ test was very underwhelming, so I'm sticking with a free online test instead. The only other addition is something called fat-free mass index, which can be derived from your weight and body fat percentage. So let's get straight into the results. As mentioned earlier, if you want to join in, I'll be publishing how-to videos for all of the tests. Starting with the obvious, we're both a year older, and unfortunately, I'm no taller. I agreed that I would stop nagging my wife about her inactivity and junk food consumption, so she's now 1.9 kilos heavier, just over 4 pounds, and has added 6 centimetres to her waist, over 2 inches. I only learned about fat-free mass index this year. If you're familiar with the calculation for BMI, it's that, but instead of your entire weight, it's only your lean mass, and you can find online calculators to plug the numbers in. We both came out as average, meaning we could do with a little more muscle mass. Blood pressure last year was on the high end of normal. Mine has come down slightly, Evelina's a bit worse. It's mainly influenced by inactivity, unhealthy eating, smoking, and being overweight and obese. If you fall into any of those categories, it's worth getting it checked. Peak flow was very similar, both of us scoring 5 worse than last year. That's the one where you blow into a tube as hard as you can, and it's a measure of lung function. Finally, HbA1c, a 3-month window into your average blood glucose levels, which is a good reflection of your diet. Last year, we were both optimal. This year, I've just crept into the normal range, and Evelina will do hers later this year. Moving on to fitness, my blood pressure cuff also measures resting heart rate, but the easiest thing to do is just to locate your pulse and count it yourself. My resting heart rate is down a few beats, Evelina's is up by 1, but it's the sort of thing that might vary by a beat or 2 every time you measure. The Queen's College step test is a 3-minute test you can do at home on the stairs, and that has me as slightly fitter and Evelina slightly less fit. Having experimented with the conversion to VO2 max, I'm now less keen on this test. Even if you input her theoretical maximum heart rate, it would still score 31. I'm tempted to substitute in the 1-mile walk test next year, which would also serve as a nice warm-up to the Cooper test. She repeated the rowing test again this year and was a little slower. Bear in mind a 2-kilometre row is a maximal test, and so it relies quite heavily on motivation. I did a Cooper test, which is running as far as you can in 12 minutes. If like me, you're not a runner, then you may have no idea how fast you should run. To help with this, I took the estimated VO2 max from the step test and worked out how fast I should theoretically be able to run. It said 3 kilometers, which would be 100 meters every 24 seconds. I ended up finding 25 seconds, a natural pace, for a total of 2.8 kilometers. That gave an estimated VO2 max of 51.5. A quick update on this. We both decided to sneak in the Rockport walking test this year. I scored 51.8 and Evelina scored 43.7. I'll try and find an alternative to the max effort rowing test, but she hates running. So if you have any suggestions, please let me know. The remaining fitness tests were more about muscular endurance. My maximum hang for time was better. Evelina had a sore hand, so only managed 15 seconds. Both of us improved our front plank and were a bit worse at the breath hold. Onto my favourites, strength and power. This is the one that should take the biggest hit with age, starting from the age I am now. Grip strength was similar. Technically, my left hand just drops out of strong into the normal range. Evelina's broad jump was a little better, mine was a little worse, but she lost a bit on her vertical. I changed the protocol for the push-ups from maximum reps in a minute to maximum consecutive reps at a given tempo. I'm not cheating, but I did just complete a 7-week push-up challenge that took my personal best to 58 reps, and I was able to crank out an even 50 here. For Evelina, it's more like a max effort strength test because she could only do 2 push-ups, which now moves her from below average to poor. I also used a set tempo for my pull-up test and improved from 12 to 14. Evelina did a flexed arm hang, which the US Marines use as a test on women, and she dropped from 13 to 11 seconds. The last category of tests is mental ability. I'm not sure how mental decline is expected to change with age, but I would expect to retain the same level until I'm at least 50. This is a battery of 11 tests on a website called Quantified Mind. I scored better in 9 and worse in 2. Evelina was the same, but she made some huge improvements in some tests, and her average was up by almost 100. Overall, I'm happy with the scores I got, but even with 2 data points, it's not easy to tell what direction the trend is going. I'm sure if I repeated all these tests next week, I'd score higher in some and worse in others, but this really is a very long-term project. The one thing I'd like to add in future years is epigenetic testing, but from what I've read, it's not at the required level of accuracy just yet. It measures your biological age, which is the age of your body and organs, and that may differ to your chronological age, which is just the number of years since your birth. The current tests on the market can differ by as much as plus or minus 4 years, which makes tracking annual changes with it a bit redundant. That's all for this year. Please keep an eye out for the playlists, which I say will hopefully guide you through all the different tests that you can do, and you can join in at home. Cheers.